Will the Mahdi be from the children of Al-Hasan or the children of Al-Husayn? Because Fatima radiallahu anha only had two children, that is it, Hasan and Husayn radiallahu anhuma. She had no other children. And the Ahlul Bayt then are restricted to Hasan and Husayn. Of course, we all know that the Rafida, they consider that all of their Imams come from whom? Which side? Husayn. And they do not give any Imams to Hasan. The reason, of course, is because they don't say this, but the reality is they are angry that Hasan radiallahu anhu gave up the Khilafah for the sake of unity. He gave his Khilafah to Muawiyah. He said, I don't want to fight. Too much civil war. We have fought too much. I give up my claim for the sake of Muslim unity. So Hasan radiallahu anhu gave up his claim. Whereas Al-Husayn, he fought, and this of course he was sincere. We of course respect all of them. They are the grandchildren of the Prophet and they are companions. We say nothing but good of them and we love them with a special love. Husayn felt that he was more qualified than Yazid and he would do better for the Ummah than Yazid. So he desired the Khilafah with a sincere intention. And he tried to go and become the Khalifa, the people of Kufa, his Shia. The meaning of Shia means the party or the group, okay? And so originally, Shi'ism was not a theology. Originally, it was a political movement. It's very important to remember this. Originally, Shi'ism was a political movement against the Umayyad. It was not a different theology. And therefore, many of the famous Imams of the Shia, in fact, all of them, they were Sunni in Aqidah. In Aqidah, in theology, they were Sunni. They were not Shia in their beliefs. But they were against the Umayyad party. It was like you have in England, you have what, Liberal Democrats, and what else do you have here? Labour Party, and what, you have different parties. Similarly, no exaggeration, you had different political parties in the Muslim Ummah. So you had people who opposed the Umayyads, and they were from the descendants of the Prophet ﷺ. They were called the Shi'at Ali and the Shi'at, or the Ahlul Bayt. Originally, it was not theological. Eventually, it became theological. So, Husayn radiallahu anhu wanted the Khilafah and he tried to approach Kufa to get his followers to help him. As you all know the story, his own followers wrote him a letter, come to Kufa, we will help you. Come to us and we will support you. And when Husayn reached literally outside of Kufa and the army that Yazid had sent also reached there, all of his followers abandoned him. Not a single person of the followers of Imam Husayn went out to defend him. Not a single person. His own followers. What happened was evil. Wallahi, it was evil. All Sunnis believe it was evil. The grandson of the Prophet ﷺ did not deserve to die this way. And whoever did this, he has blood on his hands that is not like the blood of any other person. And he shall have to respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is also said that Yazid himself, when the news came to him, he said, I never commanded you to kill him. I only want you to stop him. It is also said that Yazid did not want to kill him. It was the general of the army who wanted to kill him. That's besides the point. Getting back here, so Hasan and Husayn, two brothers. The Shia claim that all of the Imams are from Husayn. And they don't technically, you know, they don't want Hasan and his children to be of the Imams. And that is why some of the Shia even deny Imamat to Hasan. Some of the Ghulat of the Shia, they say Hasan was not an Imam. Ali and then Husayn immediately. As for the 12 Shias, the famous 12 Shias of Iran and Lebanon and whatnot, they believe Ali, Hasan, then Husayn and all of his children. So they say that the Mahdi will be from the children of Husayn. The majority of ulama of Sunni Islam, and this seems to be the correct opinion, say that the Mahdi shall be from the lineage of Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and not from the lineage of Husayn. And this is proven in a number of traditions of them, narrated by Abu Dawud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that Ali radiallahu anhu, this is not a hadith, this is Ali. Ali radiallahu anhu, look to his son Hassan. And he said, this son of mine is a Sayyid. إِنَّ ابْنِي هَذَا سَيِّد. The meaning of Sayyid is a leader, someone who will be respected. So he said, this son of mine is a Sayyid. Just like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam called him a Sayyid. Now let us pause here, let us now put a footnote. When did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam call him a Sayyid? This hadith is in Sahih Bukhari. That once the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was giving the khutbah, standing on the minbar, giving the khutbah. And as he's giving the khutbah, Husayn comes out of his house. Hasan. Hassan comes out of his house. Hassan is in Fatima's house and he just comes into the masjid and he's wearing clothes that are too long. And so he's 3 years old, 2 years old, and he trips on the clothes and he falls down, like any child would do. The Prophet ﷺ stops the khutbah, comes down, walks all the way to the crying child and picks him up, and then goes back and resumes the khutbah with Al-Hasan in his arms. Shows the love that the Prophet ﷺ had for children. And as he's giving the khutbah, he pointed to Al-Hasan, and the Sahaba are all around him. This hadith is Sahih Bukhari. And he said, "Inna bani hadha sayyid." This son of mine, meaning grandson, is a sayyid. And it is possible that one day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cause two fighting factions of the ummah to be united because of him. He shall cause peace in the ummah. This is what the Prophet ﷺ said. And indeed, 50 years later, when Al-Hasan became the Khalifa, and in the opinion of many ulama, he was the legitimate Khalifa after Ali ibn Abi Talib, and Muawiyah also considered himself to be the Khalifa, and there was going to be another civil war. After 5 years of civil war, after 30,000 Muslims had lost their lives, Al-Hasan radiallahu anhu said, "Enough is enough. I'm not going to fight for my power. I'm not going to, if you want the Khilafah that bad, take it and I will abdicate and I will step down." And so he stepped down and he then caused two warring factions of the Ummah to be reconciled. And so the Prophet ﷺ praised him and he said, "This is a leader." A leader, even though he abdicated the Khilafah, he was the leader because he wanted to unite the Muslims. So going back to the narration of Abu Dawud of Ali radiallahu anhu, he said, "This son of mine is a Sayyid," like the Prophet ﷺ called him. And then he said, "And from his children," so he's pointing to Hassan, "from his children will come a man who shall be called by the name of your Prophet. He shall resemble the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in manners and customs, but not in looks," meaning the Mahdi. So he is saying the Mahdi shall come from the lineage of Hassan radiallahu anhu and not Hussein. If this narration is taken at face value, end of story. Cut, open, shut case, as we say. This is an Abu Dawood, Ali radiallahu anhu saying, "My son Hassan shall be the father of the Mahdi." The only problem occurs, there is a very slight weakness in the chain. Very slight weakness. There's an inqita', a missing link, that's it. That one of the narrators did not meet his sheikh. And this is considered to be of the slightest types of weak hadith. Therefore, we cannot base a clear-cut evidence on this, and this is the issue. However, Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, the famous student of Ibn Taymiyyah, he also said that most of the traditions mention that he shall be from the progeny of Al-Hasan ibn Ali and not from Al-Husayn. And in this fact, this is Ibn al-Qayyim speaking, that he shall be from the progeny of Al-Hasan is a very beautiful hikmah, wisdom. And that is that Hasan radiallahu ta'ala anhu gave up the Khilafah for the sake of Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will return the Khilafah to his progeny. And Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu desired the Khilafah. He was keen on attaining the Khilafah and it was not granted to him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. This is the quote from Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala. So he is saying that this is a beautiful wisdom, that when Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu gave up the Khilafah, it is only befitting that, as the Prophet ﷺ said, when you give up something for the sake of Allah, Allah will give you something better than that. So when he gave up the Khilafah of the Muslims, his progeny shall get something better than that, which is the Khilafah of the entire world. The Mahdi shall rule the entire world, unlike the Umayyads. And even if Hussein had been the Khalifa radiallahu anhu, he would have ruled a small portion of the earth. At that time, the Muslim empire was only to Iraq and Syria and Egypt, and that is it. It had not yet reached China or Spain. This occurred in the Umayyad time. So Al-Hasan radiallahu anhu gave the Khilafah up, and insha'Allah ta'ala in his progeny it shall return and it shall be the entire Ummah. Another aspect that the Prophet ﷺ told us is that the Mahdi shall have a certain physical characteristic. He said, the Prophet ﷺ said in a hadith in the Mustadrak of Al-Hakim and also the Sunan of Abu Dawud, that the Mahdi shall have a large forehead. This place will be large, and he shall have an aquiline nose, we call it in English. A nose that is slightly pointed and long. It is in the Arabs, they consider it a sign of beauty and perfection. Okay, she'll have a straight and elongated nose, and his forehead shall be large. So these characteristics, the Prophet ﷺ told us, the Mahdi will look like. And this is not how the Prophet ﷺ looked. Just like Ali radiallahu anhu said, he shall resemble the Prophet ﷺ in manners and custom, but not in looks. So the Mahdi shall not look like the Prophet ﷺ.